this is him. What's wrong with Internet? How can Internet be so senseless? Eh? Today of all day? Eh?
What do you mean by senseless? Do you know where he could be? For being so inconsiderate.
Are you talking to me like that? Hmm? Are you? I've told you one day, I will injure you. I will teach you a lesson. One day, I will beat you. You have to talk to me like that, Abby. Bet me.
You are looking for respect, but you cannot even respect your other brother.
See, I've been warning you this house, One day, I will injure you. Bet me. Bet me. You're telling me, Abby? You're telling me? Yo, Wala, go home. Go home. I want to go to Uncle's place. See, you know what you're talking to me? I'll be warning you. Eh? One day I'll enjoy you. One day I'll enjoy you. Bet me. One day I'll enjoy you. Go home. You're challenging me, no problem. Oh, okay. You don't got a bad. I've grown wings. I'll go out.
Hold on,
sir.
Please, has Incarnate brought casket for his late brother they want to carry this morning?
No, sir. But he brought the cloth, sir.
Yes, I have seen the cloth already, but we will not do anything until he comes.
Sir, let's wait for him now.
It's all right.
Good morning, sir.
I was coming to the house. You remember today is Frank's birthday. For us to go to the match.
I was coming to your place to know if Incarnate is in your place.
No, he's not in my house. Is he not in the house?
Okay, nobody have seen him since morning. Nobody have seen Incarnate since morning. Nobody have seen him.
What do you mean by nobody has seen him since morning? Where has he gone to knowing fully well today is Frank's birthday?
Okay, I don't know. Ask me. Uncle, just ask me. I don't know where he is. Since morning, we have been looking for him. We have not seen him.
Have you tried calling his number?
Uncle, that's the problem. His number is not reachable. I don't just understand Incarnate sometimes. Nobody have seen him since morning. I don't know where he has gone to this morning.
What is really going on? Where has he gone to hid himself, knowing fully well today is Frank's burial? This is terrible.
Uncle, you see what I'm saying? Sometimes, now, if I tackle him, it look as if maybe I'm trying to drag better with him.
Okay, let's go down to the house first. Let's move to the house.
Sometimes I'm complaining about the guy nature. You look as if I'm dragging bed time with him.
I am here to take my brother's cups. Are you going to stand there looking at me as if you've seen a ghost?
Go inside and call your guy.
Daniel, good morning.
Is my brother's cups ready to go home?
Yes, he's ready. So what are you going to use to convey his cups home?
That shouldn't be your headache, okay? Just go inside and prepare him to go home.
Okay. Also, please help me and bring the casket. Help me and bring the casket.
Okay, help me and bring the casket. Let us go.
Hiya! The heart of man is full of evil. The heart of man is full of wickedness. Abonye kamga kora, unye gaza putamo, ienime. Ienime.
Number is not reachable again.
What we are going to do now is to look around and ask people questions. If there is no positive answer, where we can find him, we'll leave him and go to the mortuary.
Oh, that's the best thing to do.
Yes, exactly.
That's the best thing to do. We have to leave him and go to the mortuary. There's no longer time.
I don't understand you. I don't understand you. So.
The heart of man is full of evil. The heart of man is full of wickedness.
So as the cops is here now, what are you going to use to convey him home? I mean, like, ambulance?
Oh, I need to see my brother. So please help me, let's place it there and let me take him home.
You mainly want to use this roller to convey him home?
Oh God, there is no time, let us go, please. Help me.
Uzo, I believe that young man has not gone far. Why not rush him and ask him that same question? He will be in right position to answer you that question. Mind your business.
The heart of man is full of evil. The heart of man is full of wickedness. Abonye kamga kora, unye gazo putamo, ienime.
Where are you carrying casket to? Am I dreaming? I hope his brother's death has not affected his brain. What is the meaning of this now? Bringing caskets to my shop?
Madam, go in there and give me 2 chilled beer. 1 hero and 1 life. 1 hero for my brother. He is a hero. 1 for me, 1 life for me. So I can have life and also take good care of his family. His family. Go in there and do that.
Wait, don't tell me there's a corpse in there.
Madam, go inside and do what I instructed.
I don't have drink for sale. Honestly, just carry your brother and yourself out of this shop. I don't have drink for sale.
You think I'm joking, right? You think I'm joking? Go and see.
Him?
Yeah, so it's true. I'm not dreaming. I saw him pushing casket to unknown destination. That's why I ran to come and confirm if it's true or I'm dreaming.
Where did you see him?
This is on my road, leading to the mortuary.
My brother pushing casket? Oko?
Okay. Let's go. Let's go, let's go.
Please, can you take us to the place?
I'm going home. I have something doing at home. And just let me come and confirm.
Okay, now let's go. Let's go to the road now. Let's go to the road.
Pushing past casket.
I don't know.
What are you doing with casket again? It's not my fault.
Frank. Frank. But you have to leave me. Why? Your death was such a shock to me. I'll miss you. I'll miss you so much. I'll miss you so much. What will happen to the plans we have together? What will happen to the empire we concluded that we're going to build together? What happens to all the promise that we promised to our people? Everyone is crying. This is just a shock. You left me. You left me in this sinful world. The world full of pain and agony. Why?
Why? Why? My brother. Go well. Johnny, well. It's okay. It's all right. It's time for you to go home. But I know that your spirit is with me. Your spirit will continue to guide me. I love you so much. I love you. I love you! Frank! I know you can hear me. When you get there, always remember that you have a brother that loves you so much. It's time for you to go home. Your brothers and sisters, your people await your arrival. I love you. I love you so much.
Did Nkaneche come to this place?
He left here not long ago. He came here with casket and trolley, saying that he wants to carry his late brother's corpse. So...
What do you mean he came here with trolley? Wait, no ambulance?
No ambulance. Didn't you people meet him on your way coming in here?
No, we didn't see him. We didn't meet him at all. It's like the death of Frank has entered this boy's head.
It's possible because he was here acting strange.
Oh, good. Does that justify him coming here with trolley? Eh? Can't you go and get an ambulance?
See, you know.
Wait. Now it's making sense to me.
What is it?
I saw him the other day at Ume's shop. That Ume, the weather. Uh-huh. He asked him to construct something like we bought it for him. And I was asking him, what are you going to do with this thing? He refused to answer me. Now it's obvious that that is the reason why he was constructing
a toilet.
Yes.
Let's go and look for him before the news spread everywhere.
Uncle, where do we start from?
Anywhere is anywhere.
You know, he can
start.
By the way, the two twins, I think they two, they are behaving like twins. I think maybe he's doing for it.
Thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
You have the whole world and Umuna.
Don't tell you where I take my brother's
company. Until then, alright, go.
You have Umuna to answer to.
Right.
You took our brother, you tell me you go to last drink. What kind of last drink is that?
What the call
you? Nene Gendo. Nene Gendo, Kana Echa. Let's go home. Let's be going home, Nene Gendo.
Yes.
I thank God for the successful burial of our brother, late Frank. We pray that this kind of thing doesn't repeat itself in this family.
It's a
bad omen. People die young in a family is not a good thing. We have to grow old and enjoy our children. This is a crucial meeting, and I want us to talk about Frank's property. Sharon here will be able to give us one or two things about what she knows about Frank's property.
Uncle, you live long. You just read my mind. Exactly what I wanted to say about Frank's property. At least let her give us a briefing about our late brother's property so that we can know. Sharon, yes, here.
The ones that I know of, they're in good condition. It is only when I return back to the city I would check his document. And then, that is when I'll be able to give you a proper answer to your question. And of course, if there's any other property I don't know, tell us.
Uncle, at least let her just give us briefing about the one she is aware of. And their mama.
What?
But this is you'll be going back.
Is it even necessary, all this property?
Please, Uncle, let her mention.
I want you to drop this property thing for now. As you can see, she's not at a rightful state of mind. Nne, you're not here for interrogation. You're not here. But it's not like we do not have the right to know our brother's properties, but at least not for now. So drop this issue.
Let me ask you, Kenneth. So when will it be the right time for us to know? When is the appropriate time? Huh?
Okay. For clarification purposes, our late brother Frank has a son. He has a son, and the wife will take care of that boy for us. So even though we know about these properties, it won't be under our care. It will be under the care of the wife until the son is able to control it. So now, forget about it.
Mm-hmm. I agree with brother.
Amara, you said what I said earlier. I ignore you. At least you have used your common sense to know that this discussion is for men. Yeah? Why would you need somebody to wash plate? Who will call you to go and wash plate or sweep the house? For now, this discussion is for men.
Who is the man? You?
Yeah. Uncle? If I
Hey, hold it.
Amara, mind your words.
You don't flare up when elders are talking. Hey, when it's time you should wash plates. You, what do you do? Are you not a child? We give you money. See, you disrespected her first, so what do you expect? When an elder disrespects himself, what do you have? Umwaka woyanana. Uncle. Please, about my brother's properties, that one should be suspended for now.
Mm-hmm.
If there's another thing we'll discuss, let's discuss. If there is nothing, then let us go.
I can't understand, as the head of the family, that you just rule over the discussion we're still discussing on.
Hey. Mind yourself, I'm your elder brother.
So what? If I didn't mind, what will you do?
Uchenna.
Uncle?
Uchenna.
We cannot overlook this just like that. It's not possible. It's not possible!
I don't like the way you are talking to your senior
brother.
Calm down.
You should not blow my foot.
Uchenna. I support what Onyemaechi just said. Let us close the issue of Frank's property for now. Be outspoken. If you need properties, go out there and hustle like your age mates and acquire your own properties.
Oh,
Mama, what are you trying to say? I'm lazy. I'm not be hustling.
Hustling. I'm not be lazy. You are lazy.
What I want us to do right now is that temper is high, tension is high. If care is not taken, the exchange of blows, which I wouldn't want it happen right here now. I want us to suspend this meeting and a complaint letter.
Please. It's of this property. She must give us comprehensive list about Frank's property.
This
meeting is suspended now.
Miss Chantel.
Rose.
Yes, Mama.
How long have you been standing there?
Not quite long. But ma'am, you've been disturbed ever since we came back from late Frank's burial. I hope all is well, ma'am.
How can I all be well? I'm mean, why in God's name was someone cut Frank's life short? He was a good man. He was so helpful to me. I miss him, honestly. I wonder why God allowed such a thing to happen.
We cannot question God, Mom. He knows better than we do.
I mean, he should have left Frank for us. Instead, he would have taken that wicked Mr. Smith.
Sorry, Ma. Mr. Smith is someone's father. Sorry, Ma. I brought the case file for our client.
Then drop it.
Thank you.
I leave.
Thank you, Ma.
Government is very wicked. If they had paid me my pension, I would have done all the repairs that is necessary. Look at one of the rooms here in my house is leaking. I don't understand the kind of government you have. Don't.
Oko, good day, sir.
Ah, which one?
Oko. Well, there is a problem.
What is it?
Oko, I overheard Nkanech and Sharon. They were discussing on how to travel back to the city together. I'm suspecting something. Maybe they want to connive together and share Frank's property. And which I will not stand here and watch them do such a thing.
How is that your problem?
Uncle, it's my problem, Mo. Uncle, it's a very big problem. Huh? See, Uncle, something, I want to do something for me. I want us to be partners for you to support me so that we can convince Sharon to give us the comprehensive list of Frank's property before they can go back to this. Because I'm suspecting something there. I suspect both of them.
Uchenna, you don't need to worry. I have to talk to your mother. Then after that, I will get back to you.
So, are you trying to say that you're on my side?
Till then.
Okay.
I said till then. Don't worry. Till then.
Okay, this or till then, it's 50-50. You don't understand if you're with me or not. But nevertheless, no problem. Let me go to a gold bar.
Thank you.
So the my pension has been hanging in somebody's office and he refused to sign it. Ah. Oh, wickedness.
If you need anything, please call me.
No worry,
come on.
This particular one.
Hey!
What do you want?
Masala.
Amaka.
Bring me salad, bring me salad.
If you are coming, collect my money, oh! If you are serving food, collect my money, oh! It is very, very important. I hope everything is fine.
Very delicious. Very delicious. Hi, very delicious.
Hello, hello.
Where does it? I didn't feel so. I'm happy to come body.
Very delicious.
Where is this girl now? Huh? Where's my takeaway now? My own car. Tell her fishy side though.
I need extra, please.
Extra.
Yeah, extra.
Please, which of the extra? Is it fufu?
Yeah.
Or eba or semo?
Fufu.
Fufu?
Yeah.
I'm coming.
Thank you.
This is the fufu. Yes.
Okay.
Sorry.
Please, bring the extra soup.
For the killer of Dad, will be punished.
Come here. Come here, baby. I'm not crying, okay? Mommy's not crying. Look at me. Look at me. Mommy's not crying. Mommy's fine, okay? And tell me, have you eaten?
No, Mom. I'm not hungry. I came to check up on you.
Oh, my baby. My baby came to check on me. You're such a sweet boy. I love you. Mommy loves you so much, okay? Alright, do you know what will happen? Just go to your room and play your games, okay? Mom will come and join you soon. Alright?
If I know you're there, I will come back.
Alright, my love. I promise you, I'm gonna come back, okay? I promise you. Just go to your room and play your game quietly. Mommy's going to come join you. I promise you, my baby. Alright? Don't enjoy yourself. Be a good boy. I love you. How did he know that his father's death is not natural? I remembered everything he said to me that day. You have a lovely day at work and drive carefully. Alright?
You too, be careful yourself. And look out for dinner for me, okay?
I will.
Okay, baby.
Bye.
Daddy will not come back again.
Jesus Christ. Junior! What is wrong with you? Why will you say something like that? Yes. Now listen, Aish. Listen and listen very good. Do not say that kind of a thing of your father again. Do you hear me?
But mommy, is it not the truth?
Junior! Junior! Junior. Junior always sees things that are weird and he talks weird too. God. Please. Please help me fight this battle and get justice for my late husband. Please, I beg you. I beg you. Oh.
Bye bye.
Hold on, hold on. What's going on there? I mean, I can see people trooping in and out.
Stomach delish. You don't know here?
No.
And I hear they happen now. Now, their food now top notch. I no go lie you. Like their food they sweet. People they trooping they come out. Just wait, maybe in the next 1 hour. Here go food. People go to chop. Like people go to chop.
For real?
Eh, now that guy will get BS. Eh, now you get there now.
Sorry, dude.
Now shop business. They are the chop. Eh, now. Bye bye.
It's coming,
don't worry, okay? They will
serve you, huh? Okay,
Oh, your card.
Your plane food is 15k.
Oh, yes, it's just
very cheap.
We have the best of food here. The best of delicacies.
I know.
Yes.
I can see people enjoying it.
Exactly. Exactly. All right. Wow. We're waiting.
We might take a minute.
Take away, man. What is all this now? Serve these people there.
Wow.
Look at this kind of thing.
Where there is no AC, not even a good fan, no good environment, everywhere stinks like dead rabbit. Yet, people are just trooping in, eating like they've never eaten before. I need to call Shelley. I have to call her. Hello, Sharon. Get ready. I'm coming to pick you up. There is something very important that I would like you to see.
I hope there's no problem.
No problem at all. Just get ready.
Okay.
Which of the extra is it, Gary or Abu?
I need Abu, please.
Abu?
Yeah.
Okay.
This, you sounded so serious and urgent on the phone.
Of course. There is something I would like you to see. I'm telling you.
Sure, let me just see.
Of course, very important.
Chantal, you're scaring me. What?
Don't worry.
We're here now, so what's the big deal? The only thing I see here is restaurant activities going on, or is there another thing?
Obviously you have eyes, but you can't see with it. Just take a look at the person coming out from that restaurant. Is that not your brother-in-law?
Oh, yes. He's my brother-in-law. Maybe he came to buy food now. This is a restaurant now.
You don't get it, do you? He is the owner of this restaurant.
Ooh.
Believe me. Guess what? A plate of food in this place is sold for 15K.
15 what?
Are you shocked? That's not all. Just take a look at how people are trooping in and out. Doesn't that ring a bell?
Chantel, yes, I know my brother. My brother-in-law owns a local joint where they sell food, but I didn't know it's as busy as this. But still, I don't understand. Where are you driving at? What's your point? Because I still don't understand what you're saying.
Obviously, we are not on the same frequency. Let me take you to your place. Let's talk there.
Why is the heart of man so evil? Why is the heart of man so wicked? Why is the heart of man so evil? Why is the heart of man so wicked? What is happening to me? Oh oh. Why is this happening to me? Why oh? Who did I wrong? Who will I run to? Onye kamge besara kuwamo. Onye kamga kosara kuwamo. Ije mune luwa akari na kari. Oh God, hear my cry. Make you not allow me to be put to shame. So wicked. What is happening to me? Oh, oh.
Are you okay? Junior, how are you? Are you hungry?
No.
Mm-hmm. You're good, yeah? Okay, so you have to go to your room now, okay? I want to talk to Auntie. Alright? Yeah, okay. Come play your game.
Be careful, don't enjoy yourself, okay?
He's going to make his cat.
Yeah. Oh, he will always do that anytime. He should play his game now for now.
Chantel, if I tell you that I actually understood what you said at that restaurant, then I'm lying. Please tell me, what are you trying to say? Like, what are you trying to point at? I still don't understand it.
Honestly speaking, I'm wondering why you refuse to understand what I am trying to point out. It's not like I am trying to accuse your brother-in-law of being behind his brother's death. No. But all I'm trying to let you know is for you to remember what was so during your husband's burial, what he displayed. I mean, one should have a rethink.
To be frank with you, Chantel, I'm speechless.
Well, let it not look like I'm trying to exaggerate. Can you just give me the full details of what happened the day you lost your husband, who happened to be my colleague?
Chantel, no. What is this? What has that got to do with what we are saying now?
Believe me, everything. If you will listen to me and give me the full details, there is something I would like to analyze, you know, before I start whatever thing I want to tell you. Please.
Good morning.
Good morning. How was the night?
Fine, thank you. And you?
The night was good.
Okay.
Please, tell my brother I'm ready to leave.
Okay. I'll tell him, but I need to save your breakfast.
No. Don't bother. I have an appointment this morning, so I must leave now.
So you won't eat my food?
I've been eating your food now. For this morning, we're going to
ready. All right, no problem. Let me just inform him.
All right.
Let me just help you do that. Okay, your brother is actually waiting for you downstairs.
Oh, tell him to hold on. I'm coming down. I'm sure I'll be the one to drop him off. Has he eaten?
Well, I gave him food, but he said he's in a hurry that he will not be able to eat. I wonder why he would say that.
Ah, that sounds serious.
Yes.
Okay, just get me my suit on my car, keep this out.
Okay, baby, you're not talking your shit.
I'm coming, baby.
Frank, my brother. How are you? Good morning. How was the night now?
It was fine, and yours?
My night was good though.
My wife told me you were in your hurry.
Yes, I have to go now. You know what we discussed last night about the business?
Oh.
The young man that is supposed to give me a place for me to start my business, the new one now.
Yeah.
So he's waiting for me now. I need to go and meet him.
Oh, well, whatever is he come, just let me know, okay?
I will let you know. Why not? Are you not, after God, are you not my God again? I have to go.
No problem, but please don't forget what I told you about getting married.
That's going to be my brother agenda now.
No, I've heard you. So, but you know that it's with money now. If a man have money, getting married is not a problem. Okay, if I marry like right now, how do I feed my children? It's not me being a poor boy and I will be thinking of marriage to a woman. Who will pay my children?
No,
there's no problem. Take care.
Oh, thank you,
baby.
Daddy, please don't go to work. I had bad dream about you.
Hey, come here.
Don't say that, okay? Look at me. Nothing will happen to Daddy, okay? Daddy's gonna be fine, alright? I know you've missed Daddy so much.
Junior, I'm saying, nothing's gonna happen to me, okay?
Yeah.
And don't worry, when I'm coming, I'll get you a favor, alright?
Sweetheart, please, you just have to make out time for us. I mean, you've always been busy. You've not had time for us. Please, I beg you, this weekend, just stay with
us. Yeah, I'm sure
he misses you.
Yeah, I'm free this weekend, okay? I'll be free, okay? I'll spend time with you, baby boy.
So, you want to join Daddy, yeah?
Join me, okay?
Junior.
I'll be free this weekend, or I'll spend time with him, okay? Let me just rush.
You need to eat a little while I do.
Bye-bye, brother. Oh, he has shown you the place. So how much was the place? Okay. That means let me just send you $1,000,000 so that you can pay for the place and use the remainder to set up the place so that you can do the model. All right. Tommy.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Here's the case for you, sir.
Oh, please, I'll take those files to Shante to work on it, so that the implementation can commence. I'm not, my body system just changed. I need to rush to the pharmacy to get some drugs.
Alright, sir. Will you be coming back, sir?
Maybe, I don't know. Maybe it depends on...
Alright, sir.
My body system just changed. I started feeling dizzy all of a sudden. I want to rush to the pharmacy to get drugs.
I will just check myself for a while, but if I'm not that okay, I will just come home. Okay. I'll call you.
Hello? Yes. What? What do you mean my husband had an accident? What are you talking about? Please, what hospital? Okay, please, I'm coming. My husband has an accident! Are you serious? I wouldn't want you to see me as someone who is trying to bring problems between you and your brother-in-law. Far from it. Or maybe as someone who is trying to bring problems in your family. I don't have time for such things. But all I'm trying to let you know is for you to see what happened during Frank's burial. Just imagine how your brother-in-law
single-handedly carried his brother, who was your husband, on a roller with no genuine reason whatsoever. And before you know it, his business started booming after your husband's burial. Just within the space of a month, people are trooping in and out a local restaurant. Can you imagine? And they're selling a plate of food 15,000 naira. No AC, no nothing. The place is not even in a conducive environment yet. Do you still call that a coincidence? Listen. No woman deserves to be a widow at a young age. Just take a look at you, a very young girl, now putting on white, mourning her husband, instead of you to be enjoying your husband now. You've become a widow all of a sudden. I don't even wish such a thing to happen to my enemy, not to talk of someone that is so close to me. You don't need to cry. Hey, Sharon, no more tears. But rest assured that we will avenge your husband's death.
Chantel, honestly, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. I don't know. Oh, wait. If I may understand what you're saying, are you trying to say that my husband's brother somehow has a hand in my husband's death? Is that what you're trying to say?
Based on my analysis, I'm afraid yes. Now let me quickly take you back to the day you lost your husband. You remembered you told me that your brother-in-law, Nkameche, all of a sudden was in a hurry to leave the house. Your husband's breakfast was on the table, even the one you served your brother-in-law, Nkameche. Nkameche came down, being in a hurry to leave, and you asked him to wait so you can call Frank, so both of them can have breakfast. You went upstairs to call Frank. While you were upstairs, remember, Nkameche was on the dining. What do you think? He might have poisoned Frank's breakfast, which was why when you and Frank came down, he now said, no, he's not hungry. He needs to rush off to God knows where. And he left. Your Frank finally had his breakfast and went to walk. All of a sudden, on his way or whatever, he called you that his body system changed, that he doesn't know what is happening to him. And before you know it, he lost control and had an accident. Now let me tell you, when you poison someone, it doesn't work immediately. It takes little time. Now remember, he ate the poison. As he's leaving, the poison started working and he had an accident. Your brother-in-law tried to make it look like it was an accident. Believe you me, it wasn't. Why didn't you ask yourself, after your husband's burial, what stops Nkameche from demanding that you give him this house, you give him his brother's property on a normal? African people are known for dragging properties after such burial, but he didn't. Why?
because he has his target.
He has made provision on how to enrich himself.
No, stop!
By eliminating your husband.
No, stop!
By making you a widow at a young age.
Stop! No, it's not true. It's not true. It had better not be true.
All right, that's it.
No,
it's okay, Sharon. It's okay. We'll get justice for your husband. And my colleague, if that's the last thing I will do. To show your husband, your late husband, rather, that he was nice to everyone in the company. May his soul rest in peace. It's
all right. Chantel, I really hope this is not true. Because I swear I will come for his garnish and any other person that have a hand in my husband's death. I promise I will fight them with the last drop of my blood. I promise.
Now that's true. It's all right. You will fight in Carnage. It's all right. It's all right. Come down.
Hey.
Why is the heart of man so evil? Why is the heart of man so wicked? Why is the heart of man so evil? Why is the heart of man so wicked?
I got this for you. This is for you.
Hey.
And this is for Junior.
Junior. Come on, yeah?
Chai. It's a good move. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Junior, let me see. Thank you again.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, thank you so much.
I hope you like it.
Of course. Please, let's go inside.
No, no, no. All right.
Yo.
Amara, call Nkanecha for me.
What happened to your phone?
I said call Nkanecha for me. You're asking me some question. What's the problem?
The last time I checked, this is my phone. And you've not bought airtime for me before. So if you do not want to answer my question, forget it.
I ran out of airtime and but I will buy.
I just hope it's something reasonable you want to call him for.
Please, can you kindly remove insult from this issue? What I will not tolerate is insult. Cha, I will not tolerate it at all. I just said, help me and call him, can't you? You're trying to insult me.
Have this.
Dial the number.
Begging with pride.
That's it.
Yes.
It's
even a big cow.
It is.
We thank God though.
Yes, so thank God in heaven. And thanks to my brother, your late husband. I mean, you know he was the one that gave me the money to set up the business. Don't worry. Once you're done with money, I will personally come and take you and Junior to my shop so you can see around. And I also drive you with this car.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I will be on my way, okay?
Please drive carefully.
Yes.
I cannot afford to lose another husband.
No. Hello, Amara.
It's not Amara, it's me. See, is it not yet time for you to come so we can talk about France property so we can know how to share it?
Uchenna, I have told you anything that concerns Frank property. Do not call me about it. What is wrong with you? Eh? Frank left a beautiful wife and a child. A son for that matter. All you need now is to pray. Pray that God should bless your handwork. Let God bless your handwork so you can stop calling me because of this nonsense thing. Don't do that again. Pray for your own blessing. I'm not someone else's properties.
I'm kind of to hold on. See, Beto, did he just call the call on me?
Let me have it.
So, Garnett caught call on me.
Why won't he? When you're all about property, property every day.
If I were to slap, I'll slap you now.
Try it and see if I will not break your head. Because I've been keeping you quiet in this house, eh? Because I've been keeping you quiet.
Okay.
Try me. Try me.
Challenge yes, me.
Try.
Let me
pop your umbilical.
So you now grow wings in this house. Don't worry, I'll help you and cut it off. Mama, give way.
Kimegene, what is it?
Mama, we're going to know.
Come and be two of us.
Mama,
be two of us.
Mama, give way. So, I get it. Because you now have boyfriends in the street. No wonder. Because the only thing that can make you wait. Oh, am I the one that she's talking to?
Go and walk! Go and walk and leave property.
Shut your mouth.
Uchenna,
calm
down.
I don't
like this,
my
shit.
Uchenna, calm.
Touch me!
Shut your mouth now. Shut your mouth. Me chukwa nanu now. Yeah, Uchenna. I'll bite you.
Mama.
What's your problem now? Calm down.
He just got a new car. I'm telling you, he needed to have seen this car. Not just even a new car, but an expensive one at that. Plus, he went ahead to tell me that, once you turn morning, I'll come and pick you and Junior, and I'm going to tour you both around the town. Oh, my husband literally played a huge role in opening of his business. That was what he said. You serious? I'm glad you're seeing it now. Have you seen it? But don't worry. We really need to confront him. Chantel, I know, but you know that the court does not deal with hearsay. We need enough evidence. Yes, we need enough evidence to be able to arrest him and then take him to court. We don't have evidence, so what do we do? You better chill. Relax. All you need to do for me now is just give me approval. Just say, Chantel, go ahead. Leave the rest for me. You sure about this? 100%. Are you kidding? You'll be the bad person. You can't nurture. Chantel, if you had not opened my eyes to this, there is no way I would have ever imagined it in my head that Incarnation would do something unimaginable. I'm glad I opened your eyes.
Either you tell the candidate to do the needful, or I'll leave my own way.
Uchenna, sometimes I don't understand the way you act. What is worth doing is worth doing very well. Let's obey the customs and tradition of our people. Frank just died a few months ago. The tradition requires that he has to stay 1 year before you start talking about sharing his property.
Uncle, sometimes I don't understand you. I don't know if you are not working with Nkaneche. I don't understand your uncle. Let them share this property once and for all. Let everybody rest.
Uchenna, what do you don't understand about me?
What is it? Tell me what you don't understand about me. Uncle, let me understand.
Let them share this property. Because the way I'm seeing in Kane H and Sharon, I'm sensing they want to do Akaz on my behalf. And I don't want it. I don't want it, Uncle.
We are going to give the dead person respect.
Uncle, let the dead bury the dead.
This property you are shouting for us to share and share. Did you put 1 naira into Frank's property?
Okay, at least I contributed to his during his education. I contributed. At least I know how much I gave Frank during his education. Uncle, let it not be what I'm thinking, though. Let it not be what I'm thinking, Uncle.
Uchenna, I can see I'm going on my way.
Let it not be what I'm thinking, though.
I'm going for a meeting. Don't come here to give me this kind of situation. Share. You must have something behind your mind. Mami.
Yeah. Your car.
Yes, so not just my car, our car.
How fine and white.
I know.
Mama.
Where is she?
Inside.
Mama.
Again.
Mama, come out! Mama, come and see!
Mama, how are you?
That's new car.
Mama,
white fine car.
I'm car.
We have a new car.
Hey, Mama. I see how white. Touch.
Uchenna. Mama.
Your car.
Not my car, our car.
Mama,
the car that I will be using to drive you to wherever you want to go.
Sit in.
Go inside and sit.
Mama, sit in. See you. Come and see height.
Okay, Mama.
Mama, see.
Mama, sit down now. Sit down. See, it has remote. Oh.
Huh?
Go inside and sit down.
Mama, sit down. Face and feel.
Our car.
Mama, sit down. Face now.
Good evening, Mother.
Uriakum, my wife, you didn't tell me the last time I came to your house that you'd be coming to the village. We would have come together.
So you will kill her the same way you killed her husband?
Huh?
What?
You heard me.
Sharon, did you hear that? Mama, who is this woman? Who is she?
My lads.
What is this? Sharon! I supported you. When my brother died, I was there for you. I cared for you. For you and Junior, your son. At the end of the day!
Nkaneche, calm down.
Calm down. Please. Please. I'm begging everybody here. Let's control ourselves while we discuss.
This matter is a family matter and is a very serious matter.
See, Uncle, Ogunogoku, Adronokambode. There is no long talk in the evening sermon. Omunda are supposed to be here. Yes, let her go home and bring her people.
Well, young man, you better relax. You know, when somebody is guilty, the person is expected to act exactly the way he's acting. As for her people, time hasn't come yet. So relax. We are here for peace talk, and I'm here to ask you a few questions, only for you to keep it. And that's it. Everybody will be happy. But whereby you refuse, that's when I will involve her people. Then you will see the other side of me.
And you know you're very stupid. And I ask you again, who are you?
I am her lawyer, damn it. Now you better keep quiet.
I don't want to involve the Umunna right now. I commend Sharon here for not telling her people and bringing the matter before us. Sharon, please, can you tell us your own side of the story?
Uncle, I decided to come here to give this family the respect that it deserves by making my complaint here first. Please, you people should help me ask Nkaneche here why he has decided to make me a young widow by killing my husband. Help me ask him why he decided to involve in an evil act. Help me ask him. Ngogini Kamumelia.
Uncle, I am trying to hold myself right now so I don't do something stupid here. I do not know what has come over Sharon. Sharon, are you the one actually talking? How can I kill my own brother? My own blood brother. We're like twins. We do things together. He's my benefactor. He got me to this point that I am today. How? Sharon, I hope you and your lawyer have enough evidence. Have enough evidence to prove. Because I am innocent of this crime.
If evidence is what you're looking for, relax. You will get enough of it. Meanwhile, I would like you to explain to me your so-called uncultured action, a very useless one that you displayed in the morning of your brother's burial.
And I ask again, why should I?
I am not finished. That's one. Make sure you don't cut me off again till I'm done. Now two. Do you mind telling us how you manage to get yourself a new car after 2 months your brother was buried? Not just that, you got yourself another house. Your local restaurant that is not even in a conducive environment started booming all of a sudden. People are trooping in and out of your restaurant to the extent you are selling a plate of food 15,000 naira, as if it's a 5-star hotel.
15,000.
A plate. That's what I am talking about. Now, do you mind explaining?
Uncle, Mama, see this woman here. She is the devil incarnate. Are you jealous that I am selling a plate of food for 15,000?
I am.
Oh, you are jealous that I'm doing well. Wait. So because my brother died a few months and I started doing well in my business, and you think that I killed him? No, answer me. Does that mean that I killed him?
You haven't said anything reasonable yet. I'm listening.
This woman is mad. You are mad!
Uncle,
and I will not stand here and listen to this nonsense!
Uncle, there's no need of shouting and shouting here. I suggest the only way to solve this problem is for Nkaneche to swear. Let us involve our traditional way.
Uchenna!
If you're not my brother, if you're not my brother,
you would have killed him as well.
Hey!
I want you to complete your statement. There's another evidence. You would have killed him. That's a threat.
Uncle,
this is a serious issue. And I want us to look into this matter very well.
That means everybody in this family has to swear.
Are you mad? What? Since when? You're not head of family now. You want to make the certified you come to final say? No.
Who gentlemen? We can be strong.
I think the matter is getting out of hand. But I don't want us to change the topic. Let us remain on what brought us here. That is the most important thing.
That is very important.
Mama. Mama, please, stop worrying. Okay? I believe brother is innocent.
Ta, he's innocent. Odima is innocent. Huh? How do you know that he's innocent? Wait. Now it's making sense to me.
What?
I now understood why Ngameche has been quiet concerning Frank's property. Whenever I raise the issue of Frank's property, he will oblige to it. Now I know why he has. Hey! Mama, that's the article according to his name, Onyema Ganeche. Oh, I'm wondering, okay, we'll go big plan for himself. Ha! Hey!
Shaloke! Your mother has struck you dead overnight. Shaloke, if you don't know what to say!
Oh, what do you want to do? What do you want to do? Huh? I'm not to strike me. Oh, let me ask you. What do you want to do? You want to fight me?
Are you okay?
Did you outside try punching me? You get not say that point don't reach me. If not! Mama, he cannot kill me. It's not just that he has tried. He did not succeed. That's why he tried Frank. Hey, because Frank is soft. Okay, there. You cannot try to where I am.
Brother,
sit down.
Mama.
Just use the energy you're putting on Uchenna. Let's look for a solution. I know where this problem is coming from. I believe your innocence. And it's going to be proven. Please.
Uchenna.
Uchenna! Ah! Oh! Oh!
Ha! Mama, this one you called by name in full.
Hold these two breasts.
What do you mean by she hold two breasts? I don't understand. Mama.
I am your mother. You suckled these two breasts. I carried you in my womb for 9 months. And when I gave birth to you, you suckled these two breasts for 9 months. Good months again. And with this, I want you to hold these two breasts. Look me in the eyes under this sun and tell me you are innocent of the accusation labeled against you, that you could not have a hand in your late brother's death.
Mama, there is no need to hold in your breast. It's not necessary. I am innocent of this accusation levied against me. Mama, how can I kill my own blood brother? The man that made me see light. How? Mama, you asking me, I'm really embarrassed, I'm shocked at the same time, asking me this kind of question. You know your son, you know me very well, right from the time I was small till now. Ngebu mwado, mafuzen kibuzi, my own brother, my own brother. Oh, God.
Nka na eche.
Mama.
Nka na eche. Bole ka mpo gi. How many times did I call?
3 times, Mama.
Good. I want you, like I said, look me in the eyes and tell me the truth. Whatever you tell me here is what I will believe. And stand on it and believe you. I'm under this sun, so this sun will bear me witness that I asked you and you told me the truth. Hey, I'll be up on our own.
Mama,
tell me the truth. I am your mother. If you do not tell me, who will you tell? Who will you tell?
Mama, I am going to say it again and again. Even in my dreams, this will be my answer. I am innocent of this crime. I can swear with anything, anywhere you take me to. I will swear that I have no hands in the death of my brother. I'm telling you the truth. Believe me. If I don't open up to outsiders, I will definitely open up to you. I don't have a hand. I don't have any hand in the death of my brother. I swear to God.
Don't tell me you didn't hear the sound of my car.
I heard Madame give instructions, sir. So nobody should enter.
What do you mean by Madame gave instruction? How? Why?
That is instructions, sir.
Come and open the door. Let me go inside.
No, Madame gave instructions, sir. I step out, go out, tell Madame.
Wait. Don't you know me? Is it because I'm wearing goggles?
I know you, sir. I step out, go inside, and tell that you're here, sir.
Go inside and tell Madame that I'm standing at the gate.
Okay, sir.
Hello. What is it?
My godmother is here to see you.
To do what?
To see you, ma'am. Shall I in, ma'am?
Go and tell him that I said that if he wants to see me, he has to wait until he proves himself innocent. Okay. Did you understand what I said?
Yes, ma'am.
Now go.
I don't even do well on your matching.
It is only a fool whose house will be on fire and who will be chasing rats.
Are you referring to me?
Why are you less concerned about this issue?
Less concerned? So I should hang myself? Or I should die because Ganeche needs to prove he's innocent? Huh? Is that what I tried to say? See, I've warned you, so please avoid me. Mind your business. Avoid me in this house. I'll be warning you. I'll injure you one day.
Oh, I get it. It is because Nkaneche refused to support you in sharing late brother Frank's property. Right? But don't worry. He will be proven innocent after taking his oath.
Why do you have so much trust? To Nkaneche. You trust him so much. Why? So you believe he's not capable of doing any or to kill anybody or hurt an ant? Is that what I'm trying to say? Eh? See, don't trust anybody in this life. You end up breaking your heart. I'm telling you. Monkey say, not only in Pekin, where they in Belen, he trusts. Don't they back, you don't trust him. Because that one, if he pick something as they move, you have so much trust in him.
Well, if you say I shouldn't trust anybody, it's fine. But no stone will be left unturned after his oath is taken and he's proven innocent.
Wait, are you trying to involve me in this case?
Any man that is all about sharing your late brother's practice can do anything. And you're not an exception.
Amara. Amara. Amara.
This girl is trying me. She's beaten more than she can chew in this house. No problem. No problem.
Sharon! I know you can hear me! Sharon!
Are you here to finish what you started?
Sharon, I'm not here to make troubles, okay? I just want us to talk.
You're not here to make troubles. You bashed into my house forcefully and you're telling me you're not here to make trouble. So what do we call that?
You know that is the only way I can get your attention and you know that.
Fine. Now you have my attention, what do you want?
Sharon, I didn't do it. I am innocent of this crime leveled against me. I mean, how could you think I can kill my own brother? My benefactor? My own blood brother? See, I just came so we can talk this as a team and find a solution to all this.
And you expect me to believe what you just said now, isn't it?
See, I know this will be hard for you to believe, but you really need to believe me that I'm innocent of this whole crime. See, do not allow the enemies to infiltrate and destroy what we have shared. This will destroy our family. Please, we need to work together and find the culprit of this whole thing. I'm ready to support you anytime.
Well, I'm sorry. I cannot believe you. The only way I will believe you is if you swear that oath and still live. That is the only way I will believe you.
Sharon, in all my life, I have never killed anyone. And I will not do that to my own brother. I remember when the world was against you, I was there for you. I supported you. Fine. Fine. I am going to sort that out. But I want you to get it at the back of your head that I am innocent of this crime.
Open the gates.
Now listen and listen very well.
Okay.
Eh? Do not, I repeat, do not let anyone into my house without confirming from me. Have I made myself clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Have I made myself clear?
Yes, ma'am.
You can leave.
Chiago, welcome.
Thank you so much. Ulaka, I called you privately and asked you to ask your son properly if he is guilty or what is on the ground right now. So that if he is guilty, let's find a solution.
Chiago, I have called my son privately like you said. And he said he is innocent and I believe him.
Just like that? And you believe him?
He's my son. I know what he can do. I believe him.
Uncle, what do you mean just like that? Are you trying to say that my brother is involved in Brother Frank's death?
Listen. There's more to life when it comes to riches and making money.
But what are you even saying? Wait. Why is my brother the subject matter here? Is it that he is the only one that is capable of killing in this family?
Amara, it's okay. Your uncle is not saying that your brother is guilty. He's only trying to be reasonable. Simple.
Indeed. But I strongly believe that he's innocent.
Oh, yeah, but I'm warm. I know my son.
No problem. I think I should be on my way now.
I was looking for you.
I didn't know you are here. Frank, you've been behaving so strange these days. Is there anything wrong with you?
It's about a project I told you about now at the office. The thing is really giving me a difficult time.
Wait, the one you just told me, that big contract?
Yes. It's going to be a big open door for me and the business.
It takes 1 month, takes you 2 months, takes you 5 months or 6 months. One day, you will execute it. Eh? Don't worry about all these things. See, everything will be fine. You understand me? And you've not eaten this morning, no. Let me take you to Mama Ego. Eh? I will buy you pepper soup. Anything you want, Agede is there. You know you did not eat this morning. Eh? And also, that's your favorite hero.
You know, that's my brother.
Come, let us go. Let us go.
Let us go. Hey, Amara. Please, try it and warm that soup. Oh. Please, after 1 minute, remove that soup from where Uchenna will see it. That boy is a group.
Let us go, my brother.
Honestly, Mama Ego buying. It's like you know what I want, brother.
My brother. Are you not my brother again?
Yes,
eh?
Of course.
See, worry does not solve anything. If you think from now, till December, that worry will just go one place and go and pack and be waiting for you.
Do you even know that? I got inspiration how to go about it. See, God forbid, though, if I die before you, take me there to have my last drink before you bury me.
God forbid. How can you be talking about that?
No.
Eh? No, 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 don't talk about debt here. What are you? What kind of debt is that? See, let me tell you something. Like I told you, Wari has never sorted anything out. You understand? God forbid you will not die. We are going to grow old together.
But I mean it. It's not a joke. Take it serious.
Yeah, beginning to sound like a broken record though. don't talk about that. See, we will keep enjoying ourselves.
Yes.
We'll keep enjoying ourselves until we grow old. Eh? You see my mego's place, we'll keep going there.
Yes, sir. That place. Anytime in village, you know now. You already know my solution.
That reminds me.
It's okay. Stop thinking. I understand how you feel. To be accused of something you did not do. But I know you're innocent. And it's going to be proven.
You know I'm innocent. Why do you strongly believe I am innocent when virtually everybody thinks I am not? Everyone believes I did. I don't even care if there's a possibility of me doing it.
You are my brother. I know what you're capable of doing. We've lived together for so many years. I think family should know about each other's character and what they're capable of doing. Have you eaten?
Eat? How can I eat in this condition? What are you talking about?
Talking about something very serious, you're talking about eating. I'm not hungry. Not.
Did you do it?
What?
Stand for justice. You defend the justice.
You have always defended the just and punished the guilty ones. In kind nature, this is your opportunity. The very last one. Are you guilty or not?
I am not guilty. I am innocent of this crime.
Then step into the circle to prove your innocence.
I will take the oath on his behalf. I can't bury my two sons when I'm alive.
Allow him to defend himself. Nkaneche, you said you're innocent, right? Swear the oath.
Shut up if you don't know what to say.
If I was a
human. Hey, if you dare! If you dare! Enough of this!
Ulaka, are you sure what you have just told us? Yes, I am sure. And I'm ready for it.
Good.
Chief Priest, can she take the oath on behalf of her son?
Yes. But I hope she's aware of the consequences.
I am very much aware and I am ready.
Mama, please don't do this. Biko, let me. I want to swear now.
Madam, listen.
You are certain that your son is innocent? Then allow him swear.
I can't.
Why not?
I can't.
I feel you are too old to die. Did I just say too old? I prefer him, you know, to die instead of you.
What?
He's the one that killed somebody. Incarnation.
You said you are innocent, right?
Yes.
Allow me to take the oath on your behalf.
I am ready. Step into the circle.
Okay.
I hope you're innocent, Janet. I hope you're innocent, though.
Pick one of the egg of justice. The God of justice says, you know, the time has come. Now say after me. I, Olako.
I, Olako.
Take this oath on behalf of my son, Onyemanka Aneche.
Take this oath on behalf of my son, Onyemanka Aneche.
If he is guilty of the accusation.
If he is guilty of the accusation.
Let the thunder of justice strike me dead here and now.
Let the thunder of justice strike me dead here and now.
And let my corpse be thrown into the evil forest where the vulture and the beast will feast on it.
Let my body be thrown into the evil forest where vultures and animals will feed on it.
But if he's not guilty.
But if he's not guilty.
Let Ezudo, the God of justice, fight for him.
Let Ezudo, the God of justice, fight for him.
And vindicate him.
And vindicate him.
Turn it 3 times on your head and strike it on the ground.
I said I am innocent. I said it. Come on.
Wow. So you're actually the one that killed your brother. And you've just killed your poor mother. In other words, you've killed 2 persons. Indeed, you are a murderer. Don't worry. We'll meet in law court.
Okay. No, what do you want to do? What do you want to touch her? What do you want to do also?
I'm sorry, wait, come let me take you inside and give you your drugs. Stand up, stand up.
It's fine, just that my head hurts.
I'm sorry.
Uchechi, when did I come to your house?
Wait, did you just say my name? Say it again.
Uchechi.
You can recognize me. Oh my God, come. You can recognize me.
Of course I recognized you. What kind of dumb question is that? Why are you sounding like I've lost my memory?
Yes, so. You lost your memory.
I do. What happened to me?
Onyemanka Aneche, as the tradition demands, you are to leave this village and never to return. Even when you die in exile, your corpse cannot be returned to this village for burial. You have to leave now. And never to come back. You have no place here.
I'm going with you.
What do you mean you go with me? You take that bag inside.
I don't have your time.
Amara, please, you need to go back. Take your bag and go back. I don't want more problems for you or anybody. I don't want to rub anybody into this embarrassment. Please. I'm really grateful you've stood by me by all means. As a family. Like a sister would do to his brother.
I want to go with you. I know that something is not right. I want to stand by you till the real truth comes out. Please, let's just go.
I'm speechless. Oh,
yeah. Why is the heart of man so evil? Evil. Why is the heart of man so wicked? Wicked. Why is the heart of man so evil? Evil. Evil. Why is the heart of man so wicked? Wicked. What is happening to me? Oh, oh. Why is this happening to me? Why, oh. Who did I wrong? Who will I run to?
What happened to me? You had a car accident. Ever since you lost your memory, you couldn't recognize or remember anyone or anything. I'm so happy you're fine now.
Since when did this happen?
It's been months.
Months?
Mm-hmm.
Where's my phone?
It's inside. It's broken. It's inside.
I need to repair my phone.
No, wait. Calm down. What is it? What happened?
I need to repair my phone right now. I need to hurry to the station to report this. I think that accident happened for a reason. Yes, it's a plan to eliminate me. I'm sure about
that. Wait, wait. Calm down. How do you mean? Who wants to eliminate you? Did you offend anybody?
Where is Sir Frank?
Sir Frank, he's dead and he has been buried.
Oh my god. Who else is here?
Just a few persons.
Can you mention them?
I must confess, Chief Priest, you did a great job out there. I was too smart of you, honestly.
Thank you very much, ma. Thank you.
Thank you.
Allow me.
But no man in his right senses that will not do what I did, knowing that this beautiful body of yours will be his reward. Even the gods will betray themselves to have you.
Stop it. You're flattering me.
No, that is the truth. You're too beautiful. But let me ask you this question. You're a lawyer by profession. Why didn't you take this matter to the law courts?
Well, I would need a solid evidence to defend my claims in law court, and not just the mere fact. Well, knowing full well that Africans lie swearing oaths when they're being accused of something. So, in that way, I said, okay, I have another way to cover my claims. Which was why I contacted you, and believe me, you did well. I want all the blame, you know, to be shifted towards him. Everything, all eyes, all fingers to point towards him. Hold on, Chief Priest. How in God's name were you able to ask such smart and intelligent question an ordinary Chief Priest like you?
No. Not ordinary Chief Priest. We live in a digital world now. So I cannot afford to be naive or not educate myself. So I have to do a lot of research and enlighten myself, even if I'm a Chief Priest. Don't you agree with me?
Indeed.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers. Did a good job. You did the award I deserve.
Ooh. Allow me to go freshen up. I'll be with you later. Please drink up.
Thank you.
Hello. Uru, dear. Hey. Next word, I'll see be a Chief Priest.
Thank you.
I will not let this beautiful body go. I will make it mine forever.
Fool. Take a look at who wants to have my body. Now all attention will be shifted to the family and no one will suspect me for any reason. My guest room is dirty and needs to be cleaned up.
Hello, Ma.
Hello, Chichi. What information do you have for me?
She's in her right senses. She recognizes and remembers everything.
She's even disturbing me that she wants to go and fix her phone.
Okay, ma.
It's time to clear this whole thing once and for all.
Who are you talking to on the phone about me?
The doctor. Drugs, medicine. Doctor, drug.
The doctor.
Doctor.
That doesn't sound to me that you're talking to a doctor. Are you part of her?
Part of who?
Madame Chantel.
I'm sorry. My life was also threatened. Madame Chantel, she's blackmailing me. She said that if I don't do what she says, she's going to kill me. I am sorry. Please forgive me. I'm sorry, my friend. Please.
You're sorry?
Yes.
Then if you're sorry, you have to join me to expose her. Going somewhere without me?
No, ma. I want to go and mend my clothes. No, laundry, wash, clothes, dry clean.
You are indeed a smart girl. But you don't expect me to fall for your cheap lies, do you? Now move it.
No.
Oh, really? I've got a small toy for you that you will like. So how is it gonna be? Come in. Oh, I should pull. Nice. Let's go. Take.
What?
Take this.
Why am I drinking?
We are having a little meeting, aren't we?
But I don't like to drink.
Oh. You not wanting to drink means you don't want to tell me the truth.
Mike, I can never lie to you.
Now drink it. Take it! More. Take it more! You better not mess with me. Now where is she? Where is she?
She ran away.
And you were trying to run away as well. Is that it?
Not really.
Now you trying to run away means that you've told us something.
No, Ma. I did not tell her anything. She overheard us talking on the phone.
Oh. Well, I can only pardon you on one condition. That you will go catch her and bring her to me at once.
Ma, I don't know her whereabouts. Please. I don't want to work for you anymore. I'm tired.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to work for me again?
Yes.
In other words, you will no longer be available for me. That's all right. I would have given you an antidote for the poison drink you just took.
Mm-hmm.
Since you wouldn't be available. Have a nice day.
No.
Now you get lost. Get out. Out! Idiot. Deal with it. But say you would have at least called me instead of you coming.
It's not a big deal. Whether I come to you or you invited to my office doesn't make any difference. I'm here now.
Please, I need to step aside for you to come sit. Let me stand for you to address me. I mean, you're the CEO and the highest shareholder in this company.
Let us not make mountain out of molehills. Please sit down. Sit down.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'm honored, sir.
Yeah. I know you must have been bothered when we made Frank, the late Frank, the general manager of this company. May his soul rest in peace.
Amen, sir. And honestly speaking, I never thought of it, but I trust the board to know what's best for them in this company.
My main reason for coming here is for you to choose somebody that is very competent to take over this position, because you have been promoted to the position of CEO. And I've secured share for you to buy in this organization. Yes.
CEO. CEO, sir.
That's it.
Goodness. I'm speechless.
Look, Chantel. You have been very loyal and hardworking in this company. You deserve it. You deserve it. So, why this information has been delayed is because I've been trying to convince the board that you're the most competent. And they all voted for you. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
That's it.
Thank you very much.
Yes. That's it. You have to get wine and food for our celebration.
Sure, sir.
All right.
Definitely. I will.
You get that done. Once again, congratulations.
Thank you.
It's all right.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
My goodness. They would have at least given me a hint of what
they wanted to do. I mean, had it been they gave me a hint, I wouldn't have committed myself.
Why is the heart of man so evil? Evil, evil. Why is the heart of man so wicked? Wicked, wicked. Why is the heart of man so evil? Evil, evil. Why is the heart of man so wicked? Wicked. What is happening to me? Oh, oh. Why is this happening to me? Why, oh. Why is the heart of man so evil? Evil, evil. Why is the heart of man so wicked? Wicked, wicked. Why is the heart of man so evil? Evil, evil, evil. Why is the heart of man so wicked? Wicked. What is happening to me?
Why did you kill him? Why did you kill him?
I'm asking you! Why did you kill him?
I'm not going to say anything until my lawyer gets here.
Your lawyer? I can see you don't like it the easy way, you stubborn woman. You want it the hard way, right? Come! I believe you know them, right? The first rings the bell. Oh, now start talking. Answer me!
Can I ask you a question, officer? If you were in my shoes, and you've been working in a company for years, a certain position was kept for you, only for your younger colleague, the very one you signed his approval for him to join, and the company was given the position that was meant for you. How in the world would you feel?
You're not the one to ask me questions here. I am to do the questioning. Now tell me, why did you kill him?
What did you say?
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
That's not an answer to my question. I said, what did you see?
Nothing, ma'am. Nothing.
Good. Good for you. All right. Call your account number. I need to transfer a little breakfast money into your account.
No, Ma. Thank you, Ma. I'm not hungry.
Now, you rejecting my kind gesture means one thing. It means that you saw something. And you are not going to keep your mouth shut. And that alone is going to cause problems between you and I. The question is, what do we do to resolve this problem?
No, Ma. I promise, I didn't say anything. I'm not going to tell anyone anything.
You are such a pathetic liar. You want me to believe you? I don't believe you one bit.
Okay, Ma. Three ten. 683.
Hold on. Go on.
310.
Mm-hmm.
683.
Mm-hmm.
11.
Mm-hmm.
56.
Which bank?
Mordred Bank, Ma.
Mordred Bank. Such a local bank. Check your account. I just transferred you the sum of 200,000.
Thank you, Ma.
I'm sure you know what that means. It makes you my partner in crime. And you are going to shut your mouth. So for your own good, I suggest you keep our little secret.
Yes, Ma.
Understood?
Yes, Ma. Thank you, Ma. Bye, Ma.
Not so fast. Don't even think of resigning. Because I've got my eyes on you.
Yes, Ma. Thank you, Ma. Oh my God. Oh my God, why did I sleep over in this office? Ha! Ah! I'm dead. Oh God.
Hey. Excuse me, Miss Chanta. I was on my way to your office. Mr. Frank asked me to hand over this file to you and you should start processing it.
And why is he bringing it to me?
His body system got changed, so he rushed to the pharmacy to get some drugs and his coming back is under probability.
Indeed. Take it to my office and drop it in.
Babe, what's wrong?
Ah,
babe.
No.
You saw you came early. I hope all is well.
I have an appointment to catch up with. I need to finish up this work. Very important.
No problem. Hi, Tom.
Thank you, my sister.
How are you going?
Good morning, Mom.
Good morning, Mom.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Bella.
Yes, Mom.
I would like you to go get me rice. Rice and chicken. That should be 15k there.
Okay.
Okay. So you go get me rice and chicken and the remaining change. You want no chicken, you know, make do with it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ma.
Thank you, Ma.
Thank you, Ma. You're welcome.
God bless you, ma'am.
Bella?
Yes, ma'am.
You're going to have a reward?
Yeah, yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
This one, Madam Chantel, give you money. Say, may you go buy rice and chicken for her. May you go change.
Uh-huh. Maybe she woke up at the right hand of her bed today.
Ha!
Me, I'm even surprised too.
There is something you're not telling me.
I don't understand.
Start talking.
Abel, let me quickly hurry up.
Wait! Wait. She said we should share the money.
Uh-huh.
buy her rice and chicken.
Okay.
And bring my own money.
I don't hear you.
No,
I
forget.
I hear you.
My own share.
No, Wahala.
Wait, leave her. My just continue the way.
Thank
you.
No, Wahala.
I don't want your chicken, though.
Oh.
She's on the move now. Now you listen. No traces at all. No mistakes. Just make it look like she had an accident. Oh. Poor Bella. I'm sorry, sugar. But you saw what you're not supposed to see. Rest in peace.
So what is the substance or the charm that is being put on his chair? What is it for? To kill him, right?
It's obvious. The true theft. You think it's all about hitting your hands on the desk? You think you can scare me? Far from it, sugar. Man die but once.
And that once you spend your remaining years behind bars. I can see you don't want to cooperate with me. We shall meet in court. Let the law take its course.
Thank you.
Hey! So Chantel is this evil? I can't believe this. So Chantel has been the one behind my ordeal. And then she made me believe that it was my brother-in-law that was behind it. Hey! Sharon, how can you be so? How could I have even fallen for this? How could I have fallen for this? After everything he did for me. Chantel, it will not be well with you. Wherever you are, it shall never be well with you. Eh? Look at what I did to a man that was there for me, the person that stood for me. I even lost my mother-in-law in this call. She swore and then she died. Tell me, how do I face them? How am I supposed to face them? Tell me.
And also, madam, you are needed at the police station for some documentation before she will be charged to court.
Hey, officer. Officer, please, I beg you. Eh? Whatever thing you want me to do, I will do it. I would do anything you want me to do so that they will make sure they put that lady behind bars. Please, I will to come to the station. I will come. I will sign every document you want me to sign.
It's okay, madam. You hear from me. We'll be expecting you at the station.
All right. Thank you very much.
Take care of yourself, madam.
All right. Thank you very much, officer. Thank you. Hey. 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 Chantra. I'm so sorry for everything. I want you to know that they were not intentional. I was being manipulated by Chantel. Please. I know that I have caused so much pain to this family. Please, I beg you, find a place in your heart to forgive me, please. I'm sorry, please. Please forgive me.
Nicomara, forgive me.
I'm sorry.
Please forgive me. She's really sorry.
One doubt.
The major I don't know.
Well, I am happy I'm alive to see this day. I am happy that all the wrongs have been written right.
Your actions really caused a lot of damages to this family. Irreparable one. But I just hope God gives me the strength to forgive you entirely and totally. That will last for a long time. But I forgive you. Oh, I'm forgiving you. Binye, get up.
Kunye, 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 get up. I think we need to fix a date. A day we are going to bury our late mother. So she can also rest in peace. Why your mother Banigo?
Oh? Your uncle. We'll talk about it for peace now.